All right, it's that time. We are back. And today, we have road trip. I was kind of, like, my first reaction was, ooh! Yeah, and then I saw what's in some of them.
In the box. So, yeah. We are going to road trip through the United States.
And we're going to start out with the Ale 8-1. Fizzy with a touch of ginger, the zesty soda from Kentucky is a great thirst quencher or maybe a chaser.
So, Yale is not that bad. It's like ginger ale almost.
Yeah.
So, this might be something to cleanse our palate. God, I wanted to
try it. Okay, here we go.
All right. I prefer ginger ale over this, but it would be a great thing to cleanse your palate with just to get.
It's not bad. It reminds me of a honey lemon cough drop.
Yes, but a little more. I taste a little more hint of ginger.
Yeah. In it. All right. So we are going to start. Hey, honey.
Hi.
Hi, hubby.
Hi.
With Pearson's Nut Roll. Which it's funny because we just had girls' night where we had an adult toy party on Saturday. And the snack they had was what we call the salted nut roll. And you just take candy corn and salted peanuts in a bowl.
This is a Minnesotan favorite, by the way. I don't think it's a Minnesotan snack, but it is a Minnesotan favorite.
Yeah, so this one's like.
Like, no. I will go to the grocery store. You will find this in every candy aisle.
And my daughter likes it so much. We got her, like, what was that? A 3-pound one or something?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sucker was massive.
And disappeared.
It took her a while, but she ate it. Okay. Next is Wrap Snacks Wavy.
Okay, so here's the deal. Apparently, rappers have been trying to endorse themselves in food products. So, I don't know how this can be any different than any type of other hot sauce chip, but.
Inspired by famous rappers, these chips from Miami capture their personalities and flavor form. Like these spicy hot little boozy.
Little boozy.
Little boozy chips. The perfect snack after a heavy perp sesh.
Perp sesh is smoking a doobie. But they call it perp.
And you know that why?
Don't ask questions. I'm just very educated. I would eat these, like, on a turkey sandwich or a burger just to give it hot sauce flavor. It tastes a lot of, like, paprika. But
it's got a little bit of
a kick, but nothing.
It's a little burn. Not bad.
No.
I mean, and I'm one that I don't do spicy, so.
Okay. I like to take hot sauce and dump it on my chips.
So here we go. This is, I'm sure, a favorite for lots. Graham cracker and marshmallow filling coated by an autumn pumpkin spice coating. A unique twist to the classic Tennessee made treat.
Moon
a pumpkin pie. Moon pie.
It's a moon pie.
Pumpkin spice.
Is it pumpkin spice?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Well, pumpkin spice isn't so bad. I just don't like this marshmallow crap. It's like, maybe when
it's
I was
a peep.
When I was a kid, it might have been like, ooh, marshmallows, but this is a messy marshmallow. No. No thanks.
I don't like it.
Nope. Next, please.
Sorry. Sorry, moon pie people.
I don't really like it. Oh. First of all, Americans, quit adding pumpkin spice to everything. Seriously.
Only place pumpkin needs to be is in a pie.
Right. Oh, wait, pumpkin or muffins. I will go that.
Cougar cookies. These cookies from Washington State will give your grandma a run for her money. Chewy and soft in the middle with the perfect balance of peanuts and chocolate chips.
Is it a little disappointing that I'm a little disappointed in like that we got a road trip box. However, I'm a little scared at the same time.
I don't know.
Grandma's cookies are still better.
I don't think there's anything special about them.
No. Grandma's homemade.
Would cookies. I buy them? No.
No. Mm-mm. No. I would not.
A bright, colorful array of flavorful taffies from New Jersey. These chewy classic candies are so good, it will be hard to only have one.
It's not hard to only have one.
Make sure I take the paper off.
I don't need the whole thing. When I had braces, saltwater taffy stuck to them. Kind of fucked. What kind of hunky-dory saltwater toffee is this?
Way of flavorful.
When all the baskets go dead, needs it for laundry.
Yeah.
This is not saltwater taffee.
That's not what I think of. Saltwater taffee at all.
Where did it come from?
Ocean City.
New Jersey.
Shrevers.
New Jersey, do better.
Yeah, you can do better. Woo! I have faith in you.
Major faith. That's the...
right here, huh? Yeah. No.
That's it.
You kind of are throwing me off here.
I'm sorry.
A rich chocolatey coating surrounding a malt ball. Sweet filling, a Kentucky-made candy bar that would fulfill any sugar fiend's dream.
I like melted malt balls. Ooh, but that doesn't look... It looks like sawdust.
Kind of looks like a Charleston Chew. But dry. Oh, I like it.
Oh! No!
Hell is that?
I don't know. Where did it come from?
Kentucky, really?
Oh.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
That's nasty.
Ugh. Tangy on the outside, sweet and fruity on the inside. These zesty candy belts from Hawaii are addictive.
They look yummy. We've had different versions of this in almost every box we've had.
Yeah. There's always some.
So in a sense, this is kind of like a fun one for us. What do you think?
I'm salty or something.
Yeah. Salty. Do not taste that rainbow.
Oh my god.
That was gross. They lied. There is no tangy or fruity taste to that. That is straight salt.
God.
Why? I take back.
Okay. Hawaii.
That's wrong.
Go away. Seriously, wrong. Because you have the snack